Hey yo, let's get papers and pop mobile holes up in skyscrapers and condominiums overlooking our trunk cables. New York City, the only way to play is gritty. I want cheddar so we can front up in the 850. My old committee like the Buff L's and Lil Jiggy. Who want to test this? My city leave you chestless. It ain't shit that you can say to me when you be breathless. Young, but I done did shit that you won't do. Stick ahead with that bullshit you blab about going through. I got niggas who pump on your block and in your spot, who sit next to you protecting you, but they'll murder you, player. Don status, nigga, we getting gypsies and bad bitches, sis, frontin' clips.
Be taking odds from the out of state spots. Any nigga make it hot, get found a vacant lot. You don't really wanna come try the one guy who stays dumb hot from front line. The racket sang, sang alumni. We got more beef than an Islamic bomb. So I pack enough sonic arms to neutralize atomic bomb. It's not the nigga in your gang want it. My AK, Slate Games, Praise Jays, niggas' names on it. Often I bug and bust off in the duck. Have a Trump coughing blood, fill his cough from a slug. Yo, you know I got enough guns to wreck a nation. Any nigga wave a tech and Mason, have an explanation. You bring your crew in them, I'm doing them. Then I'm beating them down with aluminum. Then I'm putting two in them. You can't touch me, I've been devil sent. Wanted for embezzlement. A lot of other things, but that's irrelevant.
If you love the money, then prepare to die for it. Niggas gotta start something.
Yo! $2-$4 Tuesdays. Oh, y'all motherfuckers ain't pulling in front of me. Y'all crazy. $2-$4 Tuesday. Decided to give y'all another one. Like 2 weeks ago, I took Uber as a rider for the first time myself. And my wife's cousin was in town. And so we all went out and hung out downtown. We went out. So we caught the first Uber from my house and caught it all the way downtown. It's like a, we caught it all the way downtown, about like a 25-30 minute ride. And first dude pick us up in a Mercedes, a white Mercedes. I said, what the hell? So he picked us up in the Mercedes. And I told him, I said, don't y'all tell him that I'm an Uber driver. I said, I just want to see, you know, how it go, what he say, what he do. I'm gonna ask him some questions and stuff. So we got in there and we were talking to him and stuff. He's like, asking how he like it. He said he just started pretty much. He just been driving for like 2 months. I've been driving since July 2015. So like, what's that? Seven, almost 8 months. And he was talking about different stuff. So I asked him what's the craziest thing that happened since he been driving. And he was like, he said, one time I picked up this guy and he was in the car, he was talking and asking me all these questions and stuff about myself. And he said, he started trying to get, you know, close to me and stuff. I was like, I said, what you mean? He's like, he was touching on me. I said, he was touching on me. He's like, yeah. He said he started rubbing on my arm, talking about let's go to the hotel and all this shit. I was like, man, I would have put his ass out right there. Wherever he was, that ride was over. You out of here. I was like, what the hell? I said, was he in the back or he's in the front? He said, no, he was in the front seat and then rubbing on my shoulder. He said, did he rub my face? He said, he rubbed your face talking about let's go to the hotel. I said, man, hell no. But that was cool, man. He took us all the way down. We went to Front Page News, the spot downtown. It's cool, you know, being when you drive for Uber because you get to see all of the hot spots that's in town, like all of the places where people go eat and hang out and have brunch. Like a lot of these people, man, they have brunch and all this stuff and all these different little places that they go eat at. And Front Page News, it's like on the strip. It's on Crescent Avenue downtown. It's right across the street from, if you're from Atlanta, people from Atlanta, or if you know Atlanta, it's right across the street from Opera. On Crescent Street and Front Page News. It's like South City Kitchen, Lore, a bunch of like clubs and restaurants all up and down that strip. But so we went there. They had like a little rock band playing that night. We took some shots and stuff before we left. Everybody had a drink before we left. So we got in there, we feeling good and had us some more drinks while we were down there. And the food was banging, man. It's like a lot of Creole food. I had that jambalaya, the wife had steak and shrimp, and her cousin, I keep forgetting what she had. I don't remember. Oh, she had a burger because she was saying, crying about a burger. She been eating good for some weeks, so she said she just wanted a burger. But we had like appetizers like fried green tomatoes with like the tomato sauce and feta cheese on it. It was banging, man, banging. So we left there and decided to go to this other little spot downtown called 255. It was on Peter Street. This was like this, like, you know. No, it's like a lot of black people hang out down there on Peter Street. There's a lot of black clubs and black, you know, little spots to chill at down there. So we went down there, and this guy picked us up. There's an older guy, the second Uber driver named Corey. He picked us up, and he's driving this like green, like Scion or whatever, little small Toyota. Yeah, Scion, whatever. Bright green car. And he picked us up. We get in the car. We laughing, talking shit. He's like, hey, cut the shit, cut the shit. He was like, how did a guy like you end up with two beautiful ladies like this? So we was in there cracking up, laughing at him, man. He took us down to the spot. And, you know what I'm saying? He was cool. We didn't stay in his car that long. Like 10 minutes, you know, he was talking. But, yo, we saw a Lyft driver in his car. You know, you can tell the Lyft driver because they had a little pink mustache lit up on their dashboard or whatever, or on the front of their car. And the dude had new, like, loud, like, techno music playing, and damn, lights going inside of the car, like, the bright lights, you know, blue and pink and purple just spinning around, and, like, a strobe light spinning in there, and it was like a party in his car. He had Christmas lights lined up, Joe. It was crazy, man. I was like, I said, man, he did his car just like that just for driving, or, you know, I don't know how it did, what happened, how he got his car like that, but that was crazy, man. He had a straight-up party vehicle. I know he get all kinds of tips doing that, but, so dude drop us off. We got down 255, hop out. And I used to go to the barbershop that was like a couple doors down from the place we went, 255. And so we get out and I see my old barber. He tied in with a lot of people on that street and a lot of the events. He do like different stuff with parties and stuff. And I saw him and he's like, hey, let my man and his people in. So we walked on in or whatever. And then we went there, had a couple drinks and stuff. Standing over there by the bar. So me and my man Malik was talking. My old bar, we talking and stuff, chopping it up, catching up. So as I know, I look up and this girl was just like, she like laying on the ground. I was like, yo, what the hell? We didn't even see her pass out. She just passed. You know, the girl just passed out. It looked like she hit her head on the railing. Like it's like a little ramp when you leave out of 255. So she was laying there. Then the security guard was like on top of it. He was like rubbing on her chest. I said, man, why is he playing with the girl like that, right? I'm looking at him like, what's wrong with this dude? It was a security guard. But he had his fist like this, and he was raking in the middle of her chest or whatever. And Malik's like, I said, yo, what's up? This girl, like, she dead. I mean, she was not moving, yo. She was just laying there. He was just rubbing on the chest. I said, yo, what is he doing? He said, that's called a sternum rub. I said, what? I said, a sternum rub? What the hell is that? He said, it wake people up when they knocked out or whatever. He said, like, it's to create discomfort. And, rake across their chest real hard and they wake up. He said, she be all right. I said, man, that girl like she did. He said, no. He said, watch. He said, yep, there she go. She back. We got her. And then he kept on talking like, what's that going on, man? He got up. The girl had pissed all in the floor, man. I was like, oh, no, nah, yeah, it's time for us to be out this joint, man. We gotta go. So we called our last Uber driver and stuff. He picked us up in the van, he picked us up in the caravan, kind of like the one I drive, this one right here. And he had a red one. And my wife's cousin get in the car, and she tried to get to the other seat. Like, I don't have my two seats in the middle out. He had his seats up. And she got in and tried to get out of the seat, trying to walk across. She fell down in between the seats. We was tore up, man. We just had a ball that night, man. So we went over to the crib. But that was a good time, man, out there partying. But the night after that, I went out driving, and man, I was seeing all kinds of crazy shit going on. I was like driving down the highway downtown, right before you get to, I forget the name of that exit, but it's downtown when you're like going like 85 north, and you come up under one of the bridges or whatever, and the traffic was packed. I mean, it was like parking lot. You could barely move. You're doing like 10 at the most, you know what I'm saying? 20. And this dude had pulled over to the side, and standing right there pissing on the highway. Standing right there pissing on the highway. Everybody's looking like, yo, what the hell? But hey, I guess you gotta go. You gotta go. So he over there pissing. Then I was driving and I saw this. I was driving and I was over there in Virginia Highlands area, and I saw this dude was walking. He had his little glasses on and stuff, little sweater, dressed up. Now he was just walking. He was just walking and just throwing up. He was walking. He was just like, bleh. I mean, just like projectile, just shit was flying. I was like, yo, what? And he was walking in, wipe his mouth, look around, make sure I wasn't looking, throw up again, walk. Then he turned around, walked back down the street, was throwing up again, turn around, come back up the street. He was just walking and throwing up. I said, yo, what is going on tonight, man? I'm just seeing all kinds of just random crazy stuff. And then the last thing, I saw another dude pissing outside of an apartment. But he wasn't facing the building, he facing the street. Like, I was like, yo, this dude must be towed up. He said facing the street where everybody passing instead of just face the building or going to the side of the building. And then I had to use the bathroom myself, so I'm over there by a place called Maggie's, where a lot of the Emory students party at in Atlanta. So I went to this other bar called Famous or whatever. So I went in there and I'm walking. I had never been there before. I walked in and it's like pool tables, a lot of people playing pool. It was a weird mixture of people in there. Like, all the people playing, most of the people playing pool was like a lot of black people, right? Guys, girls, and couples and stuff. And then the people at the bar was like a little divider. And all the people at the bar were like white people just sitting up there, but they look like redneck looking white people. It was just a weird mix of people in there. So I'm walking to the back, I get to the back. And it was like these two doors, like, and you can see the lights going, like it was like a party back there, right? So I started to grab the door and open it to see what's going on there, but I had this bathroom. I said, I'm going to the bathroom. So I looked, and when I looked at where the bathrooms were, I saw it said women, and then so obviously right across is the men. So I turned to go into the men's, and I walk in, the door opens up, and somebody coming out, and there's, all I see is a skirt, a dress, and a ponytail. And I was like, oh, like the person walked by, I was like, oh, because I walked in the bathroom. I was like, oh, and then I backed out and I came out. And then I said, wait a minute. I looked across the room and said, women. And then I looked at it, I said, man, I said, wait a minute. What the fuck was that? Yo, dude was up in there, a big, tall, six something white dude with a dress on and a ponytail. And he went into that room over there where that party was. I was like, oh, hell. I said, yeah, I'm glad I didn't go in there, right? I said, oh, no, he can have that party. So I do my business in the bathroom. I come out. When I come out the bathroom, this big tall woman comes out the bathroom, and I could just see just Adam's apple. That mother looked at me like, I was like, oh yeah. I was like, I'm looking like, yeah, I know that you're not a woman. This is shit. And all that was back there, it was like a big trans whatever party going on back there. I said, man, this is crazy as hell, man. It was just a wild night, a wild weekend. That weekend. But hey, man, that's all I got for you, man. Y'all got two for a dollar on Tuesday, all right? I'll catch y'all next time. Hey, if you yourself like to drive for Uber, make sure you click the link below. Use promo code QHGAN and get started making you some money, all right? Peace.